Well, this is a healthy ash tree, full in green. This is autumn. You see the yellows and the browns. We'd expect to see that at this time of year. And these are the symptoms of Chalara. Brown or black leaves hung on the tree, looking like it's been hit by a frost. This is very early symptoms of Chalara fraxinea on some ash coppice. You see the leaves are starting to wilt. And over here, we've got the secondary stage, where you can see the leaves have turned brown and we're starting to see some discoloration of the leaf stem here. By contrast, here is a healthy leaf. You can see the stem is green and the leaves are green and healthy as well. This is a more advanced case. As you can see, the leaves are black and brown, still hanging onto the tree, and the stems are starting to go black and brown as well. But don't mistake ash keys, the seed of the tree, for ash leaves dying on that tree. The next symptom to look for is this discoloration of the stem. As the fungus makes its way into the stem, it changes from this olive green through to this purplish through to a brown. And here we can see the distinctive diamond-shaped lesions on the stem here of this ash, where the fungus has come in along the leaf stem and into the main trunk. Well, here's a section of a stem that I've cut. As you can see, the distinctive diamond-shaped lesion, these are often black or purplish in colour. And then if you split the stem, you can see the fungal mycelia going up and down the xylem. These are the water-carrying vessels of the tree, and this is effectively how it kills the ash by starving it of water. If you want more information on Chalara dieback and its symptoms, please visit the Forestry Commission website.